Hi and welcome. In this tutorial we will learn something that I have not covered on my blog yet, at least not at the time of this recording, and I have some other stuff in pipeline there. We're going to learn how to carry out t-test using Python. Now there are many sources that can cover the theory of t-tests, so here we will focus on the practical aspects, how to carry out independent and paired samples t-tests using Python, stats models and SciPy. And when it comes to paired samples t-tests, we only use SciPy. Make sure you check the description for useful links. Let's start with the independent samples t-test. And we're going to have a quick look at the documentation of the stats models, stats, weight stats, t-test underscore end. So we have some parameters here. x1, x2. We can set the alternative hypothesis. But we are going to focus only on x1 and x2. But we could set the alternative if it's larger, smaller. But we leave it at two-sided. And it returns the t statistics, the p value, and the degrees of freedom. All right. Now let's do some coding. First, we're going to need some data, and I'm just going to use NumPy to generate two normally distributed arrays. So this data is just going to be some variable that the subjects got drinks before watching a movie and drinks after a movie, and then they judge some kind of memory of the movie, let's say. Doesn't really matter. Import NumPy SNP and from stats models stats weight stats import t test underscore end. So this is for the t-test. So let's create some variables. Drinks before is ampere random normal 2.3, and we got some standard deviation here, and we do it 1000 times. And we can copy paste this and just change the name here and tinker around a bit with the numbers, smaller standard deviation. I'm not going into NumPy generating this numbers, but you get two NumPy arrays here with normally distributed data. And now we can just carry out the t-test. So the t-test results, t-test end drinks before drinks after. Okay, and then we can print the results. We just have to wait and see here. Yes. So here's what we get. We get the t value, we get the p value, and last we get the degrees of freedom. We don't get, however, confidence intervals. If you're familiar with using R, you know that the output from the t-test in R gives us the confidence interval. This is something that are required in many fields, such as psychology. I provide some links in the description to help you to compute this confidence interval, if you like. Now, the same test can be carried out using SciPy t-test underscore end. And here you have AB, and it would be our drink before, drink after variables. You can input an axis if it's equal variance and what to do with missing data. And here it returns the t value and the p value. So let's just try that out also. Okay, from scipy.stats import t test end. And t test sp is t test end drinks before, drinks after t test.sp. And we can see here we get the same results as using t-test underscore end from num stats models. We don't get the degrees of freedom, and as with stats models, we don't get the confidence interval. You can calculate the degrees of freedom. It's pretty simple. I'm not going into that, but it's just each variable, the length of each of these arrays minus 2, so minus the length of this minus 1 and the length of this minus 1, and it equals 1998. So let's continue with this paired sample t-test. We cannot really carry out the paired sample t-test using stats models, but we can do it using SciPy. That's cool. So let's use the same data, but just assume that the same subjects partook in both manipulations. So now these two variables are not independent of each other. They are dependent. So from scipy stats import t test rel. Okay, and t test pair equals t test rel. Drinks before, drinks after. And we can just get the output. We don't get any degrees of freedom, so we can calculate it like this. So it's the length of drinks before plus the length of drinks after minus 1. Okay, that was it. Now you know how to carry out independent and paired samples t-test using Python. We have used NumPy, stats models, and SciPy. Pretty simple. I hope you learned something, and if you do, make sure you press that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Bye.